Thank you, sir, for your warm words. I'll not take much time because I'm not going to stand in between you and the main speakers. I'm just going to trace a few events, and I've called it the footprints of radicalism. And obviously, the Bangladesh connection also in quite a few of them is visible. So I start in November 2007. This is very well known. These were the scenes seen in central Calcutta in November 2007. Many said after 1946, they witnessed for the first time these scenes in Calcutta against Bangladeshi author Taslima Nasreen and the then left front government, upholders of secularism, decided to throw her out of Calcutta, bowing down to the so-called Lumpen proletariat. Then February 2009, again during the left front regime, the famous statesman of Calcutta in one of its columns republished an article by Johan Hari, which had first appeared in The Independent, and where the title of the article was, "Why Should I Follow Oppressive Religions?" Central Calcutta Statesman House saw protests, violent protests, the entire city came to a standstill, protests continued until the Calcutta police arrested the editor and the publisher. And then they were made to apologize, and they were released on bail later on. Similar scenes were again witnessed as in November 2007. Then we come to September 2010, the Delhi incident. It's very interesting that you have Wikipedia pages also now created on these occurrences. And Delhi in North 24 Parganas, there was an altercation. A 50-year-old puja mandap was attacked because the Hindus there protested land grabbing from the Muslim community. Delhi is a predominantly Muslim district area. And for 4 days, continuous mayhem, violence, and atrocities continued. These are photographs from the ground. They are not even Wikipedia photographs. Then, of course, May 2011, there's the change of guard. There's a change of guard, but there's nothing which changes on the ground, in effect, when one tries and traces the rise of radicalism in Bengal. This picture is, of course, self-evident. This is very interesting that the mindset of ghettoization, creating exclusive zone, picked up, continuing, but it picked up post-2011. And you have a letter here, which is self-explanatory. It has been decided that a 500-bedded multi-speciality and super-speciality hospital and medical college at Bhangar in 24 Parganas South will be constructed basically for treatment of patients from the minority community in the state. And of course, we know that along with this, there was this announcement of giving salaries to imams and various other issues, religious-based reservation in jobs, etc., etc. This is just an example. I'm tracing the broadly tracing. August 2012, you had this huge protest in central Calcutta, a few meters away from the American center, American consulate, and they were protesting against the American film, which created a lot of noise last year. Now, the events continue. February 2012, Taslima was thrown out in 2007. February 2012, organizers of the 36th Calcutta Book Fair blocked the release of the 7th volume of her biography. Calcutta Book Fair also saw violent protests. February 2013, Salman Rushdie is denied entry into West Bengal. So the liberal space is shrinking. And these are again, you see the Mohammad Kamaruddin, we have a video on that later on him. He's protesting in front of the Calcutta airport and Salman Rushdie was denied entry. In West Bengal. Now, this is as late as February 2013. These are again photographs from the ground in Canning in South 24 Parganas on rumor, and Sadhyaji is here. She has written extensively on it. She was the only one to write about it in a national news portal. Otherwise, we wouldn't have known of it. Based on a rumor, a certain Maulvi was killed, and based on a rumor, the way things happened, that he was killed by Hindus, the entire Canning area, Canning police station area, saw again devastating attacks on the Hindu families, just based on that issue. Whereas later on it was realized, it was found out that these were he was killed by a rival Maulvi because he had money on him. Now, I just stretch it to Bangladesh. March, February 28th, Dilawar Hussain Saeed's verdict was out. The Jamaat went on a rampage in Bangladesh. And within 2 days, within the 1st of March, the entire thing shifted to the minority community in Bangladesh, Hindus, Buddhists, as well as Christians. And these are again photographs from Bangladesh as late as March 2013. Attacks by the Jamaat, who were protesting the hanging the verdict against the Dilawar Hussain Saeed. This is the Shaba movement. We have been following it. Obviously, the Indian media has perfunctorily covered it on and off, not in a sustained manner. But this is the huge gathering that took place in Shaba when he called it the Second Liberation War of Bangladesh. You had the entire young Bangladesh and all communities coming together to say that the Jamaat must be banned. One of their 6-point agenda demand was that Jamaat must be banned and the war criminals must be hanged. Death for war criminals. This is March 2013. Very interesting. And this is 30th March Calcutta, to which director was referring. That was against war criminals. And in Calcutta, we had a rally in favor of war criminals. And where they said that Dilawar Hussain Saeed's death would mean the death of Islam. And that the Muslims of West Bengal will protest, will throw Hasina out, and will take to task any government which supports the banning of the Jamaat. So this was just a review of the events. Now I'll just take another 5 to 6 minutes. There are just 3 short videos. The first one, these are all uploaded. Activists on the ground have done a very good job, so that at least this goes to the international audience. This is the attack, vandalization of a temple in Bangladesh on 28 February 2013.
Yeah.
issue in West Bengal and...
A mass convention called by 15 prominent Muslim organizations of West Bengal, including the All India Willi Council, or Bengal Minority Youth Federation, West Bengal Sunnat Al-Jamaat Committee, and others, was held at Kolkata Shaheed Minar Maidan, where they unitedly condemned the ongoing war crimes trial against Jamaat-e-Islami's leaders and the actions of the Sheikh Hasina government. The protesters termed the Shahbad protest as atheistic and said that anti-Islamic propaganda would not be tolerated at all.
इस्लाम और पॉकेट के नाम पे बहुत तुहीन कर रहा है और इस्लाम के खिलाफ बहुत लिख रहा है, उसके मुखालिफत करने के लिए आज हम लोग का ये जुटेशन। हम लोग चाहते हैं कि वो गुनागार जो इस्लाम के खिलाफ करते हैं उनके अगेंस्ट में बांग्लादेश हुकूमत एक्शन ले, आईनी व्यवस्था उनके खिलाफ करे और उनका अरेस्ट भी करे और इस्लाम के मुखालिफत बंद हो जाए।
Even demanded setting Bangladeshi Islamic orator and leader of the Jamaat, Dilbar Hussain Saidi, free after the war crimes tribunal had awarded him death penalty. In Bangladesh, the unprecedented anti-Jamaat protests at Shahbag Square, prompted by bloggers and activists, have pushed the Jamaat on the back foot. In a bid to discredit the movement, the Jamaat-e-Islami managed to exert pressure on the Hasina government into arresting three atheist bloggers who are believed to have defamed Islam online. Branch DB of police arrested blogger Asif Boyuddin from Segun Bagicha in the capital, Dhaka. The arrest came amid strong denouncement over the government's role, which many said was buckling under force from some radical Islamist groups.
My PhD is too cautious because already there is a big force against her and the big force of fundamentalism is working against her with support from other rival political parties.
However, in February this year, the Hasina government had also shut down 12 blogs and Facebook pages for carrying out male publicity by suspected Islamists.
Suddenly they are all being called bloggers. I don't think all of them are bloggers. They are young people, the numbers of young people there. Not, I'm sure not all of them are bloggers. Not even the majority of them are bloggers. Some among them are bloggers. But who blogging? So they, the other side, people who want to discredit this whole demand for justice, started to say these bloggers have little objectionable things in the social media. Now, recently, this thing has surfaced again to say that bloggers as a whole, things have been said against them, which I don't want to repeat. But the idea being to sort of create a kind of public impression that all bloggers are people who have said things or done things which hurt people's religious feelings. I don't know if two or three people have done it, and I don't know that they have done it, but if they have done it, what is needed from the state is to give a proper explanation. One of them got killed.
The tribunal has so far sentenced prominent Jamaat members like Abul Kalam Azad, Dilbar Hussain Saidi to death, and Abdul Qadir Mullah to life imprisonment.
I'll also ask the chairman of today's function to take charge of the procedure.